I'm sure that you all have heard about the Icebreaker Challenge. Most of you have probably done it. Do you know why it was started in the first place? That's what I'm here to tell you about. Hi, my name is Evan, and I'm going to teach you about how technology has impacted the lives of people with ALS. To begin, let's find out what ALS is. ALS, or MND, is a motor neuron disease. It affects the motor neurons in the brain, which connect to the spinal cords, which send involuntary signals throughout the muscles of the body. When these motor neurons die, the muscles lose the ability to move, and they also shrink in size and weaken. ALS causes the muscles to weaken and shrink in size, which also causes the host of the body to stop moving, breathing, speaking, and to eat and swallow. There are two different types of ALS. One's called sporadic and the other one is called familial. If you ever are diagnosed with ALS, hopefully you're not, you have a 95% to 90% chance of sporadic, so you usually have that, because familial is only caused by the family, by your parents' genes. Now I'm going to tell you what technology is being used to help people with ALS. Voice technology is being used to give voice back to people with ALS who have lost it. A tech firm called Liveward and a marketing company are making this into a very large program. They work together to recreate the voice of Pat Quinn, who is the co-founder of ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. He also has ALS while he was doing this. The other two people who made this disease very well known are Stephen Hawking from the UK and Luke Erics from the US, a famous Yankee baseball player. Both of these men had ALS. They both did die, but Stephen Hawking was able to breathe, eat, and swallow, but he couldn't move. But that did not stop him from traveling around the world and receiving awards for what he did. This was Stephen Hawking when he was young, before ALS got worse for him. And I'm back to Pat Quinn, not only because of what he did for the ALS Association and what he's still doing, was because he was the person I interviewed and gave me the idea to do ALS in the first place.